Greetings, YouTube. I work in a section of my company that uses a lot of older machines. We have a couple of newer machines. A lot of our machines are older. We get a lot of the misfit parts, parts that no one else wants because the volumes are too low. So we have to have a variety of older and newer presses to run all these different kinds of parts. And we frequently have people from other areas coming to work overtime in my cell. And it's not a problem because if they're running an all-rubber part, it's an all-rubber part, whether it's an older part or a newer part. So their experience is cross-compatible. However, they aren't necessarily used to working on the older machines. And I understand this, and I have no problem helping them. But I encountered something recently which was not just annoying for the people involved. All of us that were involved in this were annoyed by this when we finally figured out what was going on. But I think it was an intriguing philosophical point. Now, the older machines have gates, physical gates that go up and down each cycle to protect the operator from the operation of the process. The newer machines have light screens. They're infrared light screens. You break the light screen, machine stops. Now, the advantage of the light screen is that there's no moving parts. It's just you wipe it down to make sure that the screen is not obscured, and it will function. The gates going up and down is a mechanical system, and it can fail. But here's the key point. Machines that have screens, light screens, operate in the automatic mode, while those that have gates, choom, 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 work in the semi-automatic mode. And that's never, ever, ever any different. Screen, automatic mode, gate, semi-automatic mode. That's just what you do. So we had a guy working for us, and he came from an area of our company which uses newer machines. They all have screens. There are no gates where he works. Gates are a foreign concept to those folks. And he started up his press, and he was having problems, and I was trying to figure out what's going on. And I cannot diagnose what's going on, so I talked to my lead. My lead can't figure out what's the problem. We contact maintenance. The maintenance guy comes. Maintenance diagnosing a problem. And then finally, a lead from the next shift, first shift, comes in to work some overtime. She sees what's going on, comes over, diagnoses the problem in a heartbeat, and walks away. The problem? Because this guy came from the newer section, he put the machine into automatic. The machine will not function in automatic. But that's not something that those of us that work on the older machines are ever, ever going to do. So for us, that was invisible. And for this guy from the other area, you never run in semi-automatic. You just do not do that. You only run in automatic. So for him, again, it's an invisible problem. We're doing this. We're going in two different directions. Each of us thinking we are operating under separate conditions. Why would someone put this machine into automatic? You never run in automatic. And he's thinking, why would you put this machine into semi-automatic? You never run under semi-automatic. We just couldn't see it. We needed someone to walk in who has encountered this problem before and was able to look at this with unencumbered eyes. Was able to look at the problem without the preconceptions that all the rest of us were bringing. Me, my lead, and the maintenance person. All of us had brought preconceived ideas to what we were looking at. And that's never good. Try not to do that. Try not to bring a mental model to a problem. Try just looking at the problem.